Hello everyone. So today we're going to focus on how to read and write Korean handwriting. Now, I bet most of you who are beginners are having a difficult time reading any of this here. You might know some of these characters, but it's going to be difficult. So we're going to go over how to read that. And just like in just like in English cursive, the best way to know how to read English cursive was, well, when you learned it in school, but also because you know how to write it. So if I wrote something like, hello, or goodbye, it's a little bit dirty. But if I just showed you this, you would probably know how to read that because you've written it before, and maybe yours looks similar to this. Well, just in the same way, if you're going to read Korean handwriting, you'll have to know how to write it. And I mean, Korean handwriting is not taught in schools like cursive was taught. I don't know if it's taught anymore, but I don't think it is. But yeah, so let's go through and I'm going to quickly go through and teach you how to write the Korean characters, the basic ones. And I want you to pay attention to the stroke order. Stroke order, that means the order in which I'm writing the characters, where I start and where I stop. So let's go ahead and get started here. G, ka, n, na, d, ta, l, ra, m, ma, b, pa, s, sa, a, ja, cha, ka, ta, pa, ha. Now these different characters have different actual real names for them. If you're referring to them individually in the alphabet, you would say kyok, Nian, Tigur, Lir, but too complicated. I'm just going to call them by what the sound they make. So, G, N, D, R, B, 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 S. This character is either silent or has an NG sound. J, Ch, K, T, P, H. And the way I learned to memorize these in this order, because if you go to just like as if you were looking up something in the encyclopedia, which nobody does, in a dictionary, you know the order in which the topics are organized. You're going to have to know the order in which the letters are organized. And so you're going to, if you go to, let's say, for instance, a norebang, which is a karaoke place, and you're looking for a song in Korean, this is the order in which it's going to be organized. So how do you memorize this? Well, you make it into like a little rhyme, just like you would do with A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Kana tara mabasa, aja chakata paha. Kana tara mabasa, aja chakata paha. One more time. Kana tara mabasa, aja chakata paha. And the reason I add an ah to it, as in this vowel here, is just to make it easier to memorize. Well, that's how I've been taught, so, and this has helped me throughout my 7 years of living here in Korea. So these were the consonants. And now let's go through the vowels, the simplified vowels. A, ya, o. Oops, I wrote the actual consonant and the vowel. O, yo, o, yo. Keep making that mistake. O, yo, u, you, u, e. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10 vowels. Now these can be combined in different ways, but I'm just going to keep it simple and go with these. And I also memorize these in the same order as well. Aya, oyo, oyo, uyu, ui. And you practice this, you can memorize it, and it's helped me through all these years. Now, let's go through and see how we can use the stroke order and the way it's written. It's always important that you know how to write the Korean words if you want to speak it or read it. So, here in this first character, we have D, ah. And then what's that? Well, you wouldn't know unless you actually were writing Korean for a long time. This character is actually this character here, the L, Lil. Now, why does it look like that? This you can understand. You have D. Let's write it over here. D. You can understand how they write with that because the stroke order is the same. And then ah. This character here, normally it's written like that. But why would they do it like this? Because they want to write it quickly. Just like in English cursive, that would become the normal stroke orders 1, 2, 3, 4. But this is just in one stroke. You know, not very nice looking, but they're basically doing this with that and this line is actually this line and then this line is actually this line. It's nice that I can write on the tab here. So it becomes like that. And because I don't write Korean a lot, it's hard for me to replicate that. But that's how you can understand why that or how that's written. Again, that character or that part, that stroke there is this stroke. That stroke there is actually, what is it? This stroke plus they're trying to go down here. And this stroke, and then that last stroke is this one here. One. So that's what we do. That's tal, tal, d, a, l, tal. Tal, e, e, dot. Go and write it. Dot, ta, go. Chon. Oh gosh. Hua. Rul. Chu. She. This character here. Do you know which one that is? Which consonant? Yep, it's that one there. It's the D. And it's pretty simple to see here. That would be normally that, but because they wrote it so quick, it just becomes a little curvy line thing. Ta, nian, ni, yo. I'm not going to go over the meaning of this. I just want to focus on how to read it. But if you do want to know the meaning, I'll try to translate, although I'm not an expert in Korean. Tari tottago, the moon has risen. Chon harul chushidaniyo. Chonwa is call, phone call. Chushidaniyo, that you've given me. You've given me a call that the moon has risen. The bottom here, let's go over these characters. E, simple to see. This plus this, E. What is that? Well, that character is actually the peel. It's written, normally it's written like this. 1, 2, 3. That's my understanding of it. But they've written it in a way where this line is still the same, but because they don't want to mess with too many strokes, they do that, and that becomes the B. This over here, the vowel, ah, they've also shortened that. Instead of doing that, they've done that. Because they don't want to spend too much time. And this one here, it looks like an R. It looks like an R, right? Now, is there a consonant here that looks the same? Not really. This here is actually this character here, M. And the stroke order normally of the meum is 1, 2, 3. What they've done here is 1, 2, 3, but they've exaggerated that first line. And oops, I can't do it correctly because I don't write enough. But you get it. I hope so. Hopefully. Pam. E b a m. E pam. What's that? When would you do that? Right here. Again, the nian. E pam do. This character and this character are the same. But for some reason they decided to write it differently. No. M. Ooh. And the reason I think this and this character are different, again, let me write this, is because possibly this M is transitioning into this next character, just like you would in other English words, like, I don't know, hello. Oh no, let's do alphabet. Normally it's written like that, but that little extra line there transitions to the next consonant. This is not a very good example, but you get it. So I'm guessing this here is transitioning into this next character just to make it easier and faster to write. And then it finishes with the M, mu. E, pam, no mu. This night is very... Now you've know what that is. 설레고. 설레. I'm trying to write like them, but I can't really. 설레고. This character here, the G. 구. Is this one here? 구. 사. What's that? It's a combination of two characters. This plus a character I didn't write yet. That one is he. He. Lastly, yo. Let's go through and just read it one more time. Zoom in. 달이 떴다고 전화를 주시다니요. 이 밤 너무 설레고 구사해요. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed this lesson. I'll bring you another handwriting lesson in another upcoming video. All right, thanks for watching.